Number 10, water hemlock. Water hemlock, also known as muskrat weed or spotted cowbane, is one of the most poisonous plants in North America. It's identifiable by its sharp toothed leaves that can grow up to 15 inches long on a plant that's between 3 and 7 feet tall. The white flowers cluster into an umbrella-like shape, and the poisonous liquid that they produce gives off an aroma similar to raw parsnips. The plant thrives in damp areas such as alongside streams and in the wet seepage areas of meadows. It produces a toxin called Sigui toxin, a small amount of which can stimulate the central nervous system, cause violent convulsions, and potentially death. The onset of symptoms can begin within 15 minutes of ingestion and include vomiting, muscle twitching, excess salivation, pupil dilation, and nausea. In large doses, the respiratory system can be affected, and death usually occurs as a result of respiratory paralysis. It's dangerous to humans, but also to livestock, and can be a real pain for farmers to keep away from their cattle as they graze. There are ways to treat the effects of poisoning, which include injecting barbiturates or tranquilizers and providing support with breathing, but it is, of course, a better idea to stay well clear of water hemlock altogether. Number 9. Manconeal tree. The endangered manconeal tree is native to the sandy soils and mangroves of southern Florida, the Caribbean, and Central America, and is often described as being the most dangerous tree on earth. They were known by the early Spanish conquistadors, who gave the fruits of this tree the name Manzanita de la Muerte, which means little apple of death. Their small, sweet-smelling fruits have the potential to cause many hours of agony, or in some instances, death after just one bite. It's not just the fruit that is poisonous, though. The entire tree is, from the leaves to the bark, all the way to the sap. Just one drop of the milky liquid on your skin will cause it to burn. The reason for this danger is the tree's production of hypopalmin A and B, as well as several yet unidentified toxins. Don't engage with this species at all, because even chopping or burning the wood or breathing the air around one can allow small amounts of these toxins to enter your body and result in painful consequences. Number 8. Doll's Eyes. Doll's Eyes, also known as white baneberry, is a flowering plant that is native across North America, particularly in eastern Canada, the Midwest, and eastern United States. It tends to grow in moist and shady environments and flowers between May and June each year. They're easy to spot because of their striking appearance. Growing up to 2 feet tall, the most noticeable thing about them is their white berries with the purple pupils from which they get their name. The berries themselves are supported by vivid pink stems. It's a good thing that these berries aren't that appetizing, though, because they're classified as being poisonous to humans. They contain a cocktail of cardiogenic toxins, which if ingested can have a sedative effect on human cardiac tissues, effectively shutting your heart down and leading to cardiac arrest, or in extreme cases, death. The presence of these toxins in the plants means they are also occasionally used in medicine. Tiny quantities of the roots are used to brew tea that helps relieve the pains of childbirth, as well as headaches and coughs. Great care must be taken when preparing this, of course, because you only need a minute dosage to benefit from it. Number 7. Rosary pea. The rosary pea, which you may know as crab's eyes or the licorice vine, is a climbing vine that's native to India. It's an incredibly invasive species, so it's spread across warm climates, particularly in coastal regions, and can be easily identified by its dark leaves and red seeds. It's popular as an ornamental vine in landscape gardens, and the seeds are used in jewelry, but it's also one of the most toxic plants in the world. This is because of the presence of aerbrin in the seeds. This toxalbumin is a ribosome inhibiting protein and is very similar to ricin, although more than twice as powerful. The toxin contained within one seed is enough to kill a human, and the symptoms can be very painful. Inhaling seed dust can cause a fever and a nasty cough, while ingesting will lead to vomiting, mouth and throat pain, diarrhea, and abdominal cramps. This will progress to internal bleeding that will be expelled by coughing, organ failure, the collapse of the blood vessels, and ultimately death. Furthermore, there's no known antidote to the effects of aerbrin, so the best way to avoid complications is to not come into contact with its seeds. If it does happen, you should try to get it out of your body as much as possible and then hope for the best. Number 6. Stinging brush. The stinging brush is native to Australia and can inflict one of the most painful experiences imaginable if you come into contact with it. It's known locally as the Gimpy Gimpy plant and is quite common in the rainforest areas to the north of the country. A part of the nettle family, they grow up to 10 feet tall and have large heart-shaped leaves along with small fruit. The danger of these plants comes from their stinging hairs that cover every part of them. They contain a compound called moroidin, which is a potent neurotoxin. The silica-tipped hairs are designed to puncture the skin upon impact and inject the toxin directly into the body. This results in a nasty stinging sensation that will last for days, or even in some cases, for years. Red spots will also develop on the affected site and eventually join together to form a large red area of swelling. If you're stung by these nettles, the advice is to carefully remove the hairs to prevent toxins from being released, and worryingly, the application of dilute hydrochloric acid to neutralize the toxins. Number 5. White snake root. This is a perennial herb that's native to North America. The plants can grow up to 5 feet tall with white flowers and are often found in woods and brush thickets. It's a very adaptive species though, so it can grow virtually anywhere. White snake root is poisonous because it contains a toxic alcohol called trematol. This isn't directly dangerous to humans in itself, but the risk comes because of how attractive it is to other animals. Cows, for example, will eat the plant if allowed to graze near it, and they can suffer from muscular tremors, weakness, and even death. People who drink the milk produced by cows that have eaten the plant can also suffer from milk sickness and suffer from similar symptoms. Milk sickness was actually responsible for the deaths of thousands of people in the early 19th century when settlers arrived in the American Midwest and were unaware of the dangers that awaited. Number 4. Castor plant. The castor plant is undoubtedly one of the most dangerous plants in the entire world. They're grown for pharmaceutical industrial uses and can reach up to 40 feet high. The beans that grow on the plant are about 40 to 60% oil, so are valued for their uses in lubrication and uses in medicine, but they're also the source of a deadly substance, ricin. Small amounts can be ingested simply by eating the beans, but it can also be refined from the waste products of the oil extraction process. The toxin prevents the cells within a body from producing the proteins they need to survive, and in high enough quantities can cause the cells to die, which leads to significant harm and potentially death. Even if exposure isn't fatal, it can be a harrowing experience, with potential symptoms including respiratory distress, heavy sweating, bloody diarrhea, and seizures. It's dangerous stuff, and even more so considering how frequently the plant is grown and how easy it would be for someone with bad intentions to get a hold of some. Number 3. Bleeding tooth fungus. This gross-looking fungus is the Hydonellum pekii, more affectionately known as the bleeding tooth fungus. It grows in the forests of Europe and North America and is identifiable from its pale pink to black coloration, tooth-like spines underneath its cap, and the thick red fluid that oozes out of it and makes it look like it's bleeding. While this fungus isn't actually poisonous, it does contain atrometin, which has antibacterial and anticoagulant properties. This makes them useful in making remedies for some ailments, but can make you ill if consumed in high doses. This probably isn't the mushroom that's at the top of your list for eating based on looks alone, but it also has a very bitter, peppery flavor, so isn't a very useful addition in cooking. Number 2. Nepenthes. There are quite a few different species of Nepenthes, otherwise known as the tropical pitcher plant. The thing that's unusual about these plants is that they're the largest species of plant that are able to eat meat, and they have an ingenious way to capture their prey. The Nepenthes raja comes from Malaysia, and they're both the largest Nepenthes species and the biggest carnivorous plant in the world. The bowl of the plant contains water and a digestive fluid, and while their main source of food are the insects that fall in, they're more than capable of digesting small animals like rats, birds, and frogs. They also attract shrews, but instead of eating them, they digest their poop, with animals using these plants as a luxurious jungle toilet. Another species is the Nepenthes attenborei, named after the wildlife presenter. It's native to the higher regions of the jungles in the Philippines and is also big enough to trap and digest small rodents. They're relatively rare, but because they tend to grow in inaccessible places, they're safer from poachers than other tropical plants. Luckily for us, no pitcher plants currently exist that are big enough to eat a person, so they don't pose any threat to us. There are, though, models around the world that show how large a pitcher plant would have to be to consume us. The large models also show you what it might be like to be a tiny insect in a world of towering meat eaters waiting for their next meal. Number 1. Tobacco. This plant causes the most human deaths every year. Tobacco. There are more than 70 different species of the plant, which originated in South America and is now grown around the world in hot climates. The plant itself is unremarkable in its natural form, but it was discovered about 6,000 years ago that if you dry the leaves, they have an effect when they're smoked. This is due to the production of nicotine, which is a stimulant. Tobacco is consumed in various ways, such as smoking, chewing, and sniffing, but each method comes with its own risks that affect the heart, liver, and lungs, and is associated with many different types of cancer. In the 20th century, the World Health Organization estimates that more than 100 million deaths can be attributed to smoking tobacco, which is why there have been such large-scale attempts to reduce the number of people who do this as a recreational activity, especially as 46,000 people a year are thought to die in the United States as a result of secondhand smoke inhalation.